Namaste everyone, I am Sameer from Great Tense from SRS at Eskuch Taruga. Today, I am here to discuss one of my favorite topics in math, that's trigonometry. The word trigonometry is derived from Greek language. In that language, tri means three, john means angle, and metri means measurement. So basically, trigonometry means three angles measurement. So trigonometry means three angles measurement. These three angles are present in right angle triangle. I'm saying that trigonometry basically deals with right angle triangle. You all know Pythagoras theorem, right? What is Pythagoras theorem? In a right angle triangle, sum of the squares of the two sides is equal to the square of the hypotenuse. According to that, you also know the Pythagorean triplets. I take 5, 12, and 13. It satisfies Pythagoras theorem. So here, there are 6 trigonometric ratios in trigonometry. The first one is sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cos theta, cosecant theta, and secant theta. So the formula for tan theta is opposite by hypotenuse. And according to this, if you take this as theta, what is opposite? 12. 12 by 13. So the same way, the for cos theta, the formula is adjacent by hypotenuse. Tan theta formula is opposite by adjacent. And the reciprocal cos theta is reverse, adjacent by opposite. And for cosecant theta, it is hypotenuse by opposite, which is reciprocal of sine theta, which is 1 by sine theta. And secant theta is reciprocal of cos theta, we can write it as hypotenuse by adjacent. So here, we all go to the formula. And in trigonometry, the angles from 0 to 90 degrees. You have to know the values. It's very much important in all, not only in mathematics, even in physics also. So, what is sine theta value? 1 by 2. How we got this 1 by 2? I'll explain that. If you take a right hand angle, we need 1 by 2 specifically, right? I'll take this as 30 degrees. And this is 90. What is this angle? 60 degrees. And for this, for the Pythagoras triplet cost, 1, 2, 3, and 2. If sine theta is Pythagoras theorem, if you want, you can check it. And here, what is sine theta? What is sine theta? 1 by 2. So sine theta value is 1 by 2. We got in this way. If you want to find, we can also find sine 60. What is sine 60 value here? Opposite by hypotenuse, root 3 by 2. So in this way, we got the value of sine 60. Even we can find it tan 30, cos 60, all values we can find here. So we got to know that the angles, how to find the values of angles from 0 to 90 degrees. How will you get to know sine 120, cos 360, how will you get to know the greater angles? For this, there is a special topic in math, trigonometry, that's on inverse T curves. I draw it here. In a plane, it's divided into 4 quadrants. Basically, name the first quadrant, second quadrant, and third quadrant, then fourth quadrant. This first quadrant is named as on. Here, second is silver. Here, third is sea. And fourth is cups. Here the name all is given because all trigonometric ratios are positive. Here all trigonometric ratios are positive. Here the main figure is given because sin theta and its reciprocal cosecant theta are positive. Rest all are negative. And here main is given t because t for sin theta and its reciprocal cos theta are positive. Rest all are negative in this third quadrant, and fourth quadrant cup is null because t for cos theta and its reciprocal secant theta are positive. Rest all are negative. Here this is 0 degree, this is 90 degree, 180 degree, 270. Again here what angle? Next 360 degree. So here you know the value from 0 to 90 degree. Here in first quadrant all the values, all the angles lie from 0 to 90 degree. So we can write it as, after remember it will go z angle 360 also. So we can write it as 90 plus theta and 360, 90 minus theta and 360 plus theta. Here angle it lies between 90 to 180. So all angles here are greater than 90, so we write it as 90 plus theta. And all angles are less than 180, we write it as 180 minus theta. In third quadrant, all the angles lie here are greater than 180, so we write it as 180 plus theta and less than 270, so 270 minus theta. And here, in this quadrant, all angles are greater than 270 and less than 250, so we write it as 360 minus theta and 270 plus theta. So now I'm saying you why you are learning this all. If a question comes like, what is sin 120? I'll tell you. Here, where is my sin 120? In which quadrant? Second quadrant. We can write it as 90 plus theta, 180 minus also we can write. 90 plus theta, how much? 90 plus? 90 plus 30. So here, when 90 plus theta or 90 minus theta, I'll write it here. When any trigonometric ratios with 90 plus theta or 90 minus theta or 270 plus theta or 270 minus theta, we have to change the ratio. Sin changes to cos, and even cos changes to sin. Sin changes to cos, and even cos changes to tan. Then cosecant changes to secant. But if the values are like 180, 180 plus theta, or 180 minus theta, or 360 plus or minus theta, if plus theta, 360 minus theta, there is no need of changing any values. Sign remains as sign, or trigonometric just remains same itself. So here, what it changes on remains same here. Changes. So sign becomes cos. Cos 90 plus, remain is 90, 90 plus 30. We have to write cos 30. It is in second quadrant. In second quadrant, sin is positive, so it remains positive. What is cos 30? So answer is plus root 3 by 2. In the same way, we can find all other angles. Give me another example. So I will take example of cos. Cos, I take it as cos 210 degree. What is Newton? What is cos 210 degree? Cos 210, where is it? Third quadrant. So here we can write it as 180 plus 30 degree. So do we make it same cos as sin? No, it remains same. So cos 30 degree. Cos 30 degree. And in here, It is impaired when solved for a positive negative. We are writing it as minus cos 30. What is cos 30?
Root 3 by 2. So answer is